Welcome to our Introduction to Earth Sciences at Cambridge and virtual tour of the department. We are very sorry not to be meeting you in person this year. In this short talk, I will introduce you to Earth Sciences and say a little bit about how the Earth courses are structured within the Natural Sciences Tripos. Here is our webpage. Please do visit that to get a broader view of our department and in particular the research and the activities that go on there. It's really a vibrant place. So first of all, what is Earth Sciences? Quite simply, it's the physics, chemistry and biology of our planet, today and in the past. Our planet is always in the news, and so it should be. Our lives are intricately linked to the behaviour of our natural environment and the resources that it grants us. And some of the questions we concern ourselves with include: how can we forecast volcanic ash over Europe and protect human health? This image shows an ash cloud generated by a volcano in Iceland in 2010 that shut down aviation over Europe for several weeks. What do ice cores tell us about climate change? Detailed study of oxygen isotopes and the chemical constituents of tiny gas bubbles in ice tell us about past atmospheres and ice sheets. Energy is a big topic in Earth Sciences. This is a nuclear reactor, and one of the biggest challenges involved with nuclear energy is how to dispose of waste safely. And this requires engineered materials to encapsulate the waste and then a safe geological repository. Our move to cleaner forms of energy requires copper. This is copper ore and other critical metals, particularly for the development of the electric car industry. Copper largely comes from hydrothermal deposits found in subduction zones. One of our research areas concerns how copper porphyries, as they're known, are made and on what timescale. Likewise, lithium is critical for making batteries. Understanding how lithium is enriched in different geological environments is another key area of earth science. Geothermal energy utilises the heat from hot rocks deep underground. This heat might be due to the decay of radioactive isotopes in granites or the residual heat of buried magma intrusions. Another important area in the coming decades is carbon capture and storage. This diagram shows CO2 generated from the burning of fossil fuels being injected down into geological storage areas to be isolated from the atmosphere for long timescales. Natural hazards are posing an increasing risk to humanity as populations and urbanisation increases. This image shows the aftermath of the 2011 Tohoku earthquake and tsunami in Japan. In the department, we study earthquakes, tsunamis and volcanic eruptions, and we run courses on natural hazards, including their economic and social impacts. We also teach you about our planet and how it was formed. This image is a depiction of how our moon may have formed through collision of two planetary bodies. And we show you how we can deduce what the interior of our planet looks like today using seismic waves, meteorites and the chemistry of erupted rocks. And we take you through plate tectonics and our understanding of it through Earth history. This is a snapshot of the movement of India northwards after it formed when the supercontinent Gondwana broke up 70 to 10 million years ago, ultimately to form what we now know as the Himalayas. Sedimentary processes have shaped the surface of the Earth and record ancient environments which saw the rise of life on Earth and the formation of our atmosphere. And others in our department study the same kinds of processes on other planets. And here is an image from the surface of Mars. The rise of life on Earth has a prominent position in our course, ranging from the very early life on our planet, the Cambrian explosion, through to the demise of the dinosaurs and the emergence of modern mammals and birds. And this is actually a sculpture of a T-Rex, which stands outside our department in Cambridge. This is a reconstruction of a tiny dinosaur, just a few centimetres long, which is 100 million years old. Its skull was found preserved in amber. The evolutionary transition of dinosaurs to modern birds is one of the most astounding transformations in the history of life. And last but not least, we do a lot of field trips. And we believe that examining rocks in the field is the best way to understand and interpret them. It also teaches much broader skills that will be useful to you, whatever career you choose in the future, of observation, precise analysis, map making, 3D interpretation, and evidence-based deduction. Our field trips, as well as being packed full of stimulating science, are also fun. And we credit our field trips with our very laid-back atmosphere in the department, with students interacting with teaching staff on a first-name basis, and the students form a very close-knit community. So in our first year, we have a half-day field trip to Ketton Quarry, which is just an hour and a half drive or so in Michaelmas term. Then we have a week-long trip to the Isle of Arran during the Easter break. And then just before you go back to the second year, we have 10 days in Sebra. And then Southwest England is 10 days in the Easter break in your second year. And then at the end of the second year, there's a 12-day training mapping trip to the Isle of Skye, which just precedes a four-week independent mapping project, which can be anywhere in the world. And then in the third year, we have 9 days at the beginning of the Christmas break in Greece. And then in the fourth year, 8 days in Spain during the Easter break. Now, 1A Earth Sciences is a course that can be taken as one of your 1A Natural Sciences options. And you have to take 3 options plus compulsory mathematics in the first year. And the subject of Earth Sciences combines very well with both physical and biological natural sciences. It's extremely broad. And the important thing is no previous knowledge is required. So you don't have to have done geology A level or anything like that. In the second year, which we call 1B of the TRIPOS, there are 2 Earth Sciences courses available. One in igneous and metamorphic geology, so-called hard rock geology, or earth sciences, and the other focused on sedimentology, climate and geophysics. And we have field trips, as I said, to Dorset, Cornwall and Skye. Now you can do one or both courses. In part 2, you can then specialise in earth sciences and then do core courses in a range of different topics. They include climate, mineralogy, geophysics, paleobiology and so on. And you can choose to graduate then with a BA in Earth Sciences, or, and most of our students do, continue to do a Master of Science in Earth Sciences, and that's what we call a Part 3, which is the fourth year. And that involves a research dissertation and very much research-focused teaching on areas, both areas that interest you and that can be very applied areas of Earth Sciences. Now, in terms of where our students go after their degree in Cambridge in Earth Sciences, they end up in all sorts of different spheres. Some go into academia, some go into hydrogeology, the Environment Agency, the British Geological Survey, mineral exploration, science journalism, government and policy, but many others go into teaching, financial sector, consultancy, wider government posts, and into the energy sector. Now this is our department. It opened in 1731 and our building incorporates the Sedgwick Museum, which is a world-renowned museum of earth science, which is located on the first floor of our department. Now our alumni include Sir David Attenborough and Charles Darwin. Here's our common room with our current head of department here on the left, Richard Harrison. And I think you get the sense of it, a very laid-back sort of atmosphere. And here's the library, which also doubles as a student hangout, with our librarian there in the middle, Sarah Humbert. And here she is helping some of our Part 3 students bind their research dissertations. When students specialise in Earth in Part 2 onwards, and that typically varies between 25 and 35 students by that stage, Earth Sciences becomes their home, as important to them as their college environment. And in the library, as well as an array of books and resources and computers, we also have the all-important beanbag corner, where students can go for a nap at any time of the day or night. So I hope this gives you a little bit of insight into what we do and what we're about in the Earth Sciences department. We would love to see you here next year. And I'll leave you with a sequence of images of our department spaces. Thank you very much.